Okay, hi. So, sorry I missed my Monday video. I have no excuse. I just went straight to shooting and I thought I would come back in the evening and do it, but I didn't. So, my bad. So I'm gonna do this instead for today, and then I'll hopefully like try and line up some videos ahead of time so I'm not like constantly missing my deadlines. Anyway, I did this question thing on Instagram. Like, I don't know if you've been on Instagram, you've seen that there are like these Insta stories that have ask a question here type thing. And I saw a couple of people doing it. And obviously, I had FOMO, so I had to get on the bandwagon. So I asked people to ask me questions, and I got like 40 interesting questions. And that's too much to answer on Instagram because it gets annoying. So I'm just gonna make this into a two-part video and see how many I can get through. I'm gonna try and do like 20 questions today. Okay, so rapid fire style. Starting now. Yes, I'm using my mother's iPad because I'm a brat. Anyway, let us begin. Question one. Are you ready to act in a Tamil web series? Yes, I'm willing to act in anything that's not a reality TV show or a soap opera or any sort of particularly erotic slash pornographic content. And I'm also willing to learn any language ever. So just say the word and I will do it. On a scale of 1 to 10, how happy are you with your life right now? 8.5, because I feel like if you get to 10, you're doing something wrong, like you're stagnating. Maybe not, I don't know. I feel like I don't ever want to get to 10, you know? I like want more out of life. Maybe I'm greedy. Anyway, what do you pour first into your bowl, cereal or milk? What kind of psycho pours milk first? You always pour cereal first. Otherwise, if you pour the milk and then the cereal, the milk splashes and it's just, then you don't actually get that much cereal in and it's more milk than it is cereal. It's a dumb idea. Please pour cereal first. Why are we here? I think we're just an unfortunate consequence of evolution. Why we are an unfortunate consequence of evolution is something I can't answer. If I had those answers, I would be a religious leader, which I'm not, so moving on. Who is your favorite superhero? Wonder Woman, obviously. Like when I saw Wonder Woman, like the movie with Gal Gadot in it, I cried because I did not think that in my lifetime I would see a superhero as badass and amazing as Wonder Woman. And like that scene where the Amazons are training like on their horses and just like riding and like shooting arrows and jumping over things and kicking things was like, oh my God, such an inspiration. And there was like a small girl sitting next to me, and I was like, this is for your generation, baby. You can be a hero. Okay, calm down. Will you ever go back to Canada? I feel like this question comes from a place of misunderstanding that I lived in Canada. I'd never lived in Canada. This happens a lot on YouTube also, like, and Instagram. A lot of people think I lived in Canada. I've never lived in Canada. I lived in the United States of America. I have visited Canada twice and I will go back to Canada to visit or for work. But I don't think I will ever move back to the US or Canada unless it's for work. Conditions apply. So we'll see. What were you doing in the US and what are you doing now? I was in the US for my college education, for my undergrad, where I studied computer science. And then I worked at a software company for 3 years before I moved back. Now I'm a full-time actor and vlogger, I suppose. How would you replace the handshake? Dude, namaskara, dude. Just a simple namaste reduces the spread of germs. It's chill. It's the best. Romantic beach date or crazy fun do something date? The first date has to be a crazy fun do something thing because, like, if you don't really know someone and you're just like on a beach, it gets creepy, dude. Like, let's not force ourselves into that kind of situation. Romantic beach date can come later, like later on in the relationship, but you have to balance both. You can't just do one or the other, personally. मेलोडी इतनी चॉकलेटी क्यों है? अगेन, इफ आई हैड दीज आंसर्स आई वुड बी अ रिलीजियस लीडर, बट आई एम नॉट, सो आई एम गोना लीव दैट टू समवन एल्स. हाउ टू बी कूल? पर्सनली आई हैव फाउंड दैट द कूलेस्ट पीपल आई नो लाइक हैव नो शेम. दे आर विलिंग टू बी मेड फन ऑफ, दे आर विलिंग टू जस्ट बी सिली एंड बी डम एंड बी देमसेल्व्स एंड डोंट ट्राई टू हार्ड टू बी कूल. लाइक बींग योर ओन वर्जन ऑफ योर सेल्फ इज द कूलेस्ट थिंग यू कैन डू. वाओ, आई साउंड लाइक वन ऑफ दोज इंस्पिरेशनल स्पीकर्स, माई बैड, बट आई स्टिल स्टैंड बाई दैट. Would you rather go to the top of Mount Everest or the bottom of the ocean? Top of Mount Everest is really fucking cold. Sorry, bad language, not appropriate for children under 13 or 16, I don't know. But I went to Bhutan recently and it was really cold. And I don't think I want to go further up into the mountains, further into the cold, because I am not like a cold person. Like, I don't enjoy the cold at all. So bottom of the ocean is the other option. Also, I've seen some really cool documentaries, like Nat Geo things, like Animal Planet and all. But the bottom of the ocean is so creepy. Like, there's all these like weird alien-y type animals, and it's super dark, and it's super like high pressure, like literally, not figuratively. So I definitely want to do scuba and like hopefully one day go super deep in the ocean the way these divers have for these Nat Geo videos. So yes, mountains or beaches, as I said, I'm not good with the cold, so beaches. But that being said, mountains have definitely gone up in my ranking of like beautiful places to visit. Like, I think a mountain with like a body of water is my favorite combination. So like the Rocky Mountains where I went while I was in Canada to Jasper National Park, there were like the Rocky Mountains and lake in front of it, like lakes in front of it. That is super beautiful, personally. Wheat, ale, stout, lager, which beer do you prefer? I'm just gonna say that I'm like a seasonal beer drinker. So I do like the wheat beers in the summer and like stouts in the winter, because you have to drink seasonally. You can't just drink whatever, whenever. How old am I? I am 27. Let's get over this whole like women never reveal their age. It doesn't matter. There's nothing more like attractive about being younger. I feel like I've gotten my shit together as I've gotten older. So I'm very proudly going to say I'm 27. I do not want to be 18 or 21 ever again in my life. Thanks. Once was bad enough. When did you know it was the right time to switch careers? I did not know it was the right time to switch careers. It was just something that had been like gnawing at me for a long time. And then I just arbitrarily set a date when my rental lease was ending and I was like, I'm done. I'm out. You'll never ever know. You just have to pull a number out of a hat and just commit to it. How long did it take to adjust in India after you moved back from the US? I would say it took like a full year. A full year to really feel like I was back, because there are a lot of like little things that you have to adjust to, like calculating the cost of things in dollars versus rupees, remembering to switch on the geyser, because you don't have to use a geyser in the US. Walking on the left side of the road as opposed to the right side of the road. You can't drink water out of the sink. That's something I had to readjust to. So just like little behavioral changes that you have to make, like that is what takes the longest, I think. Which is stuff that you don't have to really deal with if you're visiting a place. But like when you live there, you have to readjust. So yeah. What do you think of the Netflix series Sacred Games? Honestly, I've read the book and I'm really, really attached to the book, because it's the best, like one of my favorite books ever. Like, I think I've talked about that in a different video. I love it so much that I'm a little afraid of watching the show, because then my version of Sacred Games, which is in my head, is going to be replaced, which is what happened with the Harry Potter movies, and I really don't want that to happen again. But I've heard really good things, especially from the friend who like recommended the Sacred Games book to me to begin with, so I guess I'll watch it and I'll let you know. How about a day out of Durvashi? Dude, I would love to do that, except my phone has only like 16 GB storage. So it's going to fill up super fast. Like, I would have to delete all my apps to make enough video content for the entire day. If you follow me on Instagram, I promise my Insta stories, I'm like a user abuser of Instagram stories. Like, literally, I post on Instagram stories maybe like 5-6 times a day. So if you ever want to do like a day out with me, I think Instagram is the best option right now, until I have enough money to upgrade to a phone that has more storage than this. Okay, that was 20 questions. I tried to go as rapid fire as I could. Hopefully this video is not too long, and I'm gonna do a part 2 another time. Bye. Oh, sorry. Okay, bye.